our final shell game here.
Fun fact, huh?
Fun fact.
Fun fact. Fun fact. Khalil shuffled them all around. Hey guys, I am Brian. This is Khalil.
We are Beers of a Feather, a show that brings great questions
with even better beers. Today, we are at Seek Beer Company here in San Diego, California. One of the hottest locations around. You hear it everywhere we go. Everywhere all you hear is seek.
Yeah,
what a great name. We seek them out.
Love it.
What do we got going on here today?
We have Dave Omer. He is the owner here at Seek Brewing Beer Co, and he is also the beer the brewmaster as well. So he brews all the beer. He's a master at his craft, actually. Yeah,
setting up today, man. He was like bouncing everywhere, checking everything. Yeah. Like nothing stops here.
Yeah, I can tell he's a very, very hard worker, and that just must be like that's the reason why this company is so successful so far. I mean, you're doing great.
Well,
killing
it. That's good to hear. You know, we're busy and running around here like crazy, so you don't always get to go out and hear it from everybody else. So it's good to hear that people are talking. It makes me feel good.
Every brewery we go to, it's, oh man, have you guys been?
Have you done Seek yet? Well, try it.
You guys are like the hot topic. You are the pulse of the industry right now. Super excited. Beautiful location. Love the igniter setups here.
Such
a cool, patio to your branding. You guys are killing it.
Yeah. Great. That makes all the hard work and running around, a little more worth it. But yeah, it is a small team, and I wear a lot of the hats, and that's just where we're at right now. But it's growing faster than I expected. So it's exciting and a little nerve wracking, but that's okay. That's what we signed up for.
Good problem.
That's awesome. Yeah. And you've been in the brewery like business for a while now, right?
Yeah,
20 years plus.
Yeah, a little over 20 years. Started at the bottom. Washing kegs, sweeping floors, begging to learn more and do more. And
awesome.
Been just coming up through it ever since. And it was finally time to do our own thing.
That's so awesome.
Nice.
Speaking of, I think we should try the first one.
Oh, yeah. So the first one we're going to be going right to left is the pills.
Yeah.
This
Fortune
one.
Fortune pills.
Fortune pills.
Yeah. Nice German pilsner.
Nice. Cheers.
Cheers.
Absolutely.
And like I was saying earlier when we were chatting, this is the only sort of staple that we do here repeatedly. I think this is batch 4 since we've opened, and it's more just our like everyday drinker when we're all done with our shift. This is what we want to have, it's an easy drinking, simple recipe.
Yeah,
it's just all about technique, time, and care.
Yeah.
Other than that, like the ingredients are all just simple. Easy, exactly what they should be, right where they should be, and then after that, it's just drinking and enjoying.
That's what you expect from the pills.
Yeah, right? Absolutely.
That is absolutely like what you expect.
Supreme drinkability.
Yes. Yeah, pilsner malt, Hallertau Mittelfrüh hops with a little bit of spalt in there, and then 3470 yeast, and then thyme after that.
I like it.
Oh, that's a fun beer.
Yeah. Yeah,
I can. That's definitely like end of the day, and end of the episode. I need to bring myself and have a nice,
relax right after work.
And that's what it's for. We try to keep everything pretty balanced in there, so you get a little bit of everything. Get a little readiness right up front, and even like sort of cracker, like sort of plain white cracker, and then enough hops to like sort of keep that sweetness at bay, and just keep the quenching your thirst just enough, that right amount of bitterness, nice hop aroma, and we let the yeast also have a little say in the final product too.
Oh yeah,
I like that, the white cracker like saltines.
Yeah,
like I every time I do this, somebody will say, one of the brewers will say something like that, and I'm like, dang it, that's it. That is what I was just tasting, and it's in the back of my head. And that's why I love doing these with you guys, because I can taste it. I'm not a super taster, so I have a real hard time distinguishing like between each beer. But when you say something like that, I'm like, dang it, that is it.
Yeah.
That is it. I just need that prompt to, like, this is what you should be tasting. And sure enough, it does. It comes out.
Right.
I mean, tell me you don't taste.
Oh, yeah, for sure. For sure.
It's like, okay, now I'm like, hey, I'm sick. I'm going to be like, tell my wife, like, can you give me some saltines and pills for the seals?
It's what does the body good. It's,
yep.
What you'll need.
Yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, that's a big part of it. We do it a lot, you know, in the industry. We have to write these descriptors, and you have to get better at it. Like, it's something you can work on. And we've had other guys, like, actually, just then, fine, go taste a cracker. You know, as you're sort of thinking about these things, you know, when you're going through all these other beer descriptors and they sort of name it and throw out a bunch of other ones, you know, you go smell that fruit that they're talking about, and it'll forever be in your mind. Then so next time you get that flavor somewhere, you'll immediately pop onto it, and you'll be like, yep, there's that saltine cracker, there's that white bread, you know.
I love it.
Nice. So this is actually our first episode here at the Igniter. We do plan on hitting the rest of them eventually. I actually wanted to ask a question. How do you feel about being at this program, the Igniter program? Is there any, like, competition between you guys, or is it just, like, how do you feel about that? I mean, I do think this is a great program, actually. Like,
yeah.
I mean, just to give yourself a chance to get out there and build yourself up. So,
and it allowed us, you know, to do it with, you know, the budget that me and my wife had. Didn't have to bring in, you know, a lot of other investors and, you know, funding.
Right.
So it was great for that. You know, we probably wouldn't be here, or it would have taken a lot more time to get here to San Diego without this program. Mm. So no, there's some challenges within that too, because you're sort of walking into somebody else's built brewery. You know, might not have been exactly how you would have designed it or something like that, but you make that work. You know, the benefits outweigh the challenges there.
Yeah.
And then this one being, you know, in a building with two others is unique. It's great for the customers, and we've always, you know, appreciated that. And yes, there's some natural competition, just naturally. You can't, you know, get away from that when you walk out there and see people, you know, how many Sikh beers, how many other beers they have at the table. You know, they're sort of judging it. And that can also be a judge of, you know, how good you're doing and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But we all know that we're better all together than we would be separate, because one person, that's a lot of varieties. One group can come pull up to a picnic table, try three different breweries, and they're all going to find something they like between us.
Yeah. And that goes into this whole community. The brewery community is such a close knit. Everybody really supports everybody in this industry.
Yeah.
And I think that's such a cool thing. Just like you're saying, even though you're competing, you're really together. And, you know, the customers are going to have a good beer walking around. In this specific location, they got plenty to choose from. You're right. They're going to find something that they like. And if they don't, then maybe they should go to whiskey.
Yeah.
Because there's three great breweries right here. So I'm just saying. Just going into the next, I really want to try this next one.
Yeah.
Okay. Looks like we're moving on to To Be a Catalyst.
To Be a Catalyst.
Yeah. Seek to Be a Catalyst.
Seek to Be a Catalyst. I love that name.
Yeah, it's cool. The other one, you know, was built for Seek Fortune.
Nice and hoppy. I can smell the hops on this one.
Good. I can't say I remember all them right off the top of my head. This was a few brews ago, but.
I like this one.
Yeah, I get a nice, like, grapefruit rind. Citrus, and then it goes really dank after that, and I'm not upset about that at all.
I like the dankiness.
That's your catchphrase on that.
Yeah, I like my beer nice and dank.
Yeah.
Seek to Be a Catalyst. I love that name. That is awesome.
Cool. And I, you know, I think that's an important thing. You know, if you want change, you got to get out there and make it happen. You know, seek to be that catalyst of change. And you know, of fighting for something you believe in. And so I think it sort of fits with what we like to do, you know, and what we sort of stand for.
I love the branding and the flow through that you guys have on every product you put out. It's more than just putting out a product. You guys have so much thought into everything you're doing. And you can see it just the littlest things. You can see that you really thought.
Yeah.
And you just, you know, think tanked it, and this is what we're going to do, and this is how it's going to be. And
details always matter, and details are what can set you apart. You know, it's
right.
The small details that stop you from being at that next level, and paying attention to as many of them as you can sort of hold into your head and, you know, get to, only, you know, I think helps the end product.
Yeah, that completely makes sense.
I like this, man. This is
nice.
You're right. So you get that citrus,
mm-hmm.
and then the hops, it's just light. You know,
it's hoppy, but
it's light.
Yeah.
So you're not.
It's not overpowering. It's not burning.
I'll be able to enjoy my next beer.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. We try to push big flavors in a balanced way.
Balanced.
You know, if all of them are at this level, then that's all right. You know, one's here and the others are, you know, all down through here. At, you know, when there's this one spike, you know, then that's where out of balance comes into play. But with these and our West Coast moving out here from Central or East, we knew we had to step up our West Coast IPA game. And we feel we've got better at it. I think this is one of the best iterations we've had so far. And I'm happy with the direction they're going.
I like the bitter in it. I like how you just had it reminds me of growing up and seeing like my parents, my mom eating grapefruit and she put like a little sugar on it for breakfast and stuff that. I get so much of that grapefruit finish at the end in the bitter that it just brought back a whole bunch of memories for me. It's a fun beer.
Yeah. So speaking of different like regions, did you like bring any of like your styles from Ohio/Tennessee over here to the West Coast? Would we see that in any of your beers? Because I haven't been able to go out there and try any breweries over there, so I don't know what kind of styles they like or what they prefer out there.
Yeah.
Will we see any of that style or any of that inside some of your beers here?
I think so. I mean, I think it's naturally going to come out. You know, I do believe bringing a sort of new approach to San Diego, you know, has been beneficial for us. You know, so many breweries within any town usually stem off of another brewery and, you know, and the naturally techniques, flavors, what you like, what you don't, you know, are going to travel with that lineage. And it's nice to come in with a fresh approach. You know, like I said, I think that can set us apart in some areas. But so many breweries out here are doing awesome things. It's definitely, you know, we're not doing anything groundbreaking and, you know, too crazy. We're just trying to do it all well.
I say it all the time. You guys have the same products as far as the building blocks, and you guys have a different beer than your neighbors. They have the same product and building blocks, right? So it is so much the chef that's in the kitchen and a lot of this. And you can tell in here what we're tasting that you really have honed your recipes and your approach to your new beers. Because like you were saying earlier, you're not going to see the same beers all the time here. Yeah. That's not how you do your business. You're about bringing new quality craft to the consumer all the time.
Yep.
And so that takes a lot as well coming up with these new recipes and new things all the time.
No, we definitely brings as many challenges as it does benefits. But those are challenges that are on me and the team to come up with a new label, come up with a new idea, come up with a new beer, come up with a new name, all that stuff. You're constantly doing it. And, you know, I don't mind putting that challenge to the team and myself if it benefits the consumer. And that's our goal there is for, you know, be very tap room driven. So every time you come here, there's a new beer, or if not multiple new beers on menu for you to try.
Yeah.
Speaking of new beers.
Living three.
All right. This one's definitely looking like a haze. You know that.
I did the same thing. That last one just kind of kept going down.
Yeah. Did we go fun fact next and then? Nope. That's domino theory, isn't it?
Fun fact.
Number three is fun fact? I'm thinking number three is domino. I couldn't do that. I didn't set him down on the table.
Well, this was the hazy.
They're both.
And I don't know. I have no idea.
So Khalil did the whole like shell game here.
Yeah.
Just a second ago. So I think you're right though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Domino theory. Domino theory is the name sort of comes from. This is the first beer that like sets off the next round of hazies that are coming. It's a hazy pale ale, so just at 6.2%.
Yeah.
And when we get in a new pitch for our hazy yeast, we do a lighter one first, and then a little bit higher ABV on the next one, and then we start rolling to some double IPA hazies, and then maybe finish it out with a triple IPA,
that.
and then that yeast is done, and get ready for the next round. So the domino theory name means it just started the...
Oh, I thought, wow, this is the beginning right here.
Cool. Yeah.
Nice. I like so that. Cool. Cheers, guys.
And this one is also for my lovely wife, Nikki, the other partner of Seek.
Cheers.
This is her sort of favorite style. She likes lower ABV hazies that... So, you know, when we're here, we can have a couple of them and not, you know...
Not get trashed.
Yeah, exactly. After one pint or something like that.
That's awesome. This is some good beer. I like it.
Great. And this is another example of like trying to pack in as much flavor, as much hops into a lower ABV beer as possible. You know, just because you're watching your alcohol level for the day doesn't mean you need to sacrifice flavor and everything else.
So I mean, it seems like that's where a lot of companies went.
Yeah.
They're like, because I think they thought it was like psychologically, right? It's like, oh, if it's super clear and thin, I think it's going to be low alcohol content, right?
Yep.
And, I mean, you could technically get a really high alcohol content with a very thin, clear-looking beer. So it's kind of just more of the mindset. And I think it was the wrong way to go. Because I think having something visually appealing would be just as important as everything else.
Yeah.
And so this is just a really cool-looking beer. And for the beer camera, they're going to see it because it is such a cool contrast in the hazy when we're rolling the film on it, and is just as what you can see is what you're tasting. It's got a full mouth, really a fun beer.
Yeah,
it has a certain unique taste to it. That's for sure. I don't know what it is, but maybe it's the different hops or some kind of flavoring that you're putting in.
Yeah, I get it. I like it a lot on the tropical side versus like Catalyst, passion fruit and guava.
Nice.
Big passion fruit to me.
They taste that. Yeah.
Yep. Very like overripe in that sort of on the verge of funky tropical flavor, you know, where like those sort of unique tropical fruits can get. I like that a lot.
Yeah.
Some beer with a Hawaiian shirt and and order one of these with that. Bring your own little umbrella for it, because probably
there you go. So, how many barrels come with the igniter program? Are they all the same, or is
So in this building, all three brewing setups are the same. Same brew house, same cellar is in number of fermenters and size of fermenter. Everything's the same. 10-barrel brew house,
10 barrels.
All 20-barrel fermenters that they provide, and then I've since added more. And then, you know, they really set you up with the big equipment that you need.
Yeah.
And then the small things that you prefer is what you bring in and add to the
I like that.
To the setup. Yeah, it really...
Cool idea.
It is great. Like I said, it got us into the game. It got us open easier than we would have been able to had we not gone with this program.
How long have you guys been open for?
Year and a half. We're approaching a year and a half now. So April...
Do you have any...
22.
Man, you guys came in with a splash, though.
Yeah.
You really guys have really come in with a splash. And the Igniter program is such a cool thing because it's not just you. I mean, you're just another one of the major awesome companies coming out of this program.
Yeah.
You know, Pure Project with beer. Yeah. You know, Epic was Obi.
Yeah, we're in the actual space Epic started in.
Yeah,
nice. I mean, that's how I discovered it. I came to have some of their beer, talking to the guys on that day, and then I went back and told him, I was like, you'll never believe it. I won't tell you all about it.
Such a cool promo.
And we heard they were moving out, and we reached out.
Nice.
We want it.
We want it, yeah.
Do you have any plans on moving out, or is it you guys are just going to just be here for a while?
We're going to be here
for a while.
You know, we've got dreams that we'd love the direction we'd like to see it go, but we don't put a lot on it. You know, don't put a lot of pressure on it. If it goes a direction, it goes a certain direction. But we still have a little bit of runway here to keep going, a little bit of capacity. So, the next, I think for us would be, a satellite tasting room or something like that. And then we'll start thinking about more.
Nice. Yeah. That's a good idea.
Absolutely.
Yeah, for sure.
So we got our final shell game here.
Fun fact, huh?
Fun fact.
Fun fact. Fun fact. Khalil shuffled them all around. Oh, man, that does have a distinct smell.
Yeah.
I see why you were able to pick that one out.
Yeah, it helped me.
Yeah.
It wasn't anything special I did there. I just know this one. This one's all Nectaron and Mosaic. So Nectaron being New Zealand hops. Some interesting New Zealand flavors that are always coming out of there. That little bit of funky, sort of diesel-y flavor with this underlying pineapple. And then Mosaic with its uniqueness and funkiness. And then like sweet fruit berry.
I'm tasting the Mosaic for sure.
Oh, yeah.
I recognize that one. Yeah.
I wanted to see how those two hops sort of played together. I knew it was going to be a pretty funky but big aroma coming out.
Yeah,
it does.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely like up in your face.
Yeah.
I've gotten like a really big love, like since we've been doing it for hazies.
Yeah.
I'm loving the hazies, and both of these two hazies are really good. They have their own distinct taste. They're not like, they don't taste similar or anything like that. So, I mean, either one you go with, they're going to be good. You're going to like them both. They both have their own flavor
it's
to
interesting,
it.
Interesting, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, like they're completely set apart.
Mm-hmm.
We've definitely, you know, and for me, it was 2015. I was brewing at Whole Foods in Houston, and we took a trip up to the Northeast, and, you know, I had my first Heady Topper, first Lawson's, and all these beers, and I was just blown away. We returned back to Houston, and I just said, nope, shut it all down. We're doing hazies now. and I think we got lucky that we, like, you know, it was right at the forefront of that trend in Houston that really helped. And the trend was really starting to spread west from there, from the Northeast. And, you know, I think we just caught onto it. And so for the longest time, it was just all, you know, people couldn't get enough of them. And so,
yeah, for sure.
2015 to 2020, I mean,
yeah,
it was all we were brewing it all the time.
Now, were you living in Houston?
Yeah.
Okay. What part?
I was in the Galleria area where the Whole Foods opened that first brewery. Yeah.
It's a nice area.
Yeah, it is. We enjoyed that part of town. And, you know, San Diego definitely fits us better, but Houston was a great stop for us. And I'm really, you know, great part of my career, really like allowed us to do a lot of cool things. And,
well, we're glad you're here.
I'm glad to be out.
Not just me, but a big portion of San Diego craft drinkers are happy that Seek made. Good.
Yes. We love it out here. This is that move to Houston opened up the West more for travel to us. And my wife, for work, traveled out here. She's like, Dave, we got to get out to San Diego with me on my next visit. And we both just fell in love with it. We were coming here all the time. I was just taking along on all our work trips. Come out here, try beers, you know, enjoy all the great nature and things San Diego has to do. And we just knew one day, some way, we needed to get out here because it fit us so well. We absolutely love it. So this is how we made it happen.
That's awesome. I love that.
Yeah.
Well, guys, Seek Brewery here in San Diego, California. You got to check it out. Newcomers coming with a storm, man. I mean, I'm just, everywhere I go, it's about Seek. Everywhere I go, I'm excited to see. Are you guys going to be competing more in the awards?
We do a little bit. We'll be sending some off to GABF at that time right now. Yep. Everybody's
looking at
preparing for it. I'll be shipping mine off first thing next week. But I haven't a ton in the past, and I don't, you know, go over and above and brew special beers for it as much. But we're definitely throwing our hat in the ring.
Nice. I wish you luck with that. I think that you guys have a great product. It's going to go far. I mean, I mean, the fact that the community loves it is just goes to show you the craft that's here. So cheers.
All right.
Thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for coming out.
Thanks.
Beers of a Feather, guys. Seek Brewery.
Seek Brewery has joined the flock, guys.